Hey guys, welcome back to my channel.
Needle type and size is most important in hand embroidery. Depending on the style of hand embroidery you are trying and the fabric and thread you use, the right needle will make or break your embroidery project. It's important to pick the right needle type and needle size. How to choose a needle type? There are three types of needles you need to make friends with right way: embroidery, chenille, and tapestry. Embroidery needles are the thinner of the three. They are usually long with a very sharp point, designed to move easily through embroidery appropriate fabric. That's muslin, cotton, linen, or Osnaburg. And needles usually have medium long eye that's easy to thread with your floss of choice. They are used for general surface embroidery, crewel work, gold work, white work, and practically any embroidery technique that requires a sharp needle. Crewel needles come in sizes 1 to 12, with 1 being the largest and 12 being the finest. Purchasing a variety pack is a good idea. Variety packs commonly include sizes 1 to 5 or 3 to 9. Both packs are good to have on hand. Chenille needles have sharp points too, but they also have a larger eye and thicker form than embroidery needles. They work well on the same fabrics as embroidery needles. Chenille needles come in sizes 13 to 28, with 13 being the largest and 28 being the finest. Chenille needles are used in surface embroidery, crewel embroidery, chenille embroidery, and any time you want a large, long eye to accommodate your thread and a sharp tip to pierce your fabric. Tapestry needles have a large eye but a blunt point. That's great for canvas work or countered cross stitch on Ada fabric. The blunt tip of the tapestry needle helps us avoid piercing the fabric threads while we stitch. Tapestry needles come in sizes 13 to 28, with 13 being the largest and 28 being the finest. They are used primarily for counter thread work and needlepoint, or any needlework on fabric or canvas that has open holes that determine where each stitch is placed. How to choose needle size? The needle should be able to pull the thread through the fabric fairly easily without allowing too much abrasion on the thread as it passes through the fabric. Although there might be a soft noise as the rest of the thread passes through the fabric, there should not be a loud zipper noise. Although you may hear a pop as the needle passes through the fabric, there should be no real resistance in the fabric when pulling the eye of the needle through. If there is resistance, if the fabric is pulling and denting and you really have to fight to get the needle through, that's a sign you should be using a larger needle. The hole the needle makes should be large enough for the thread to pass through, but not any larger. The needle should not leave a visible hole around the thread. Needle organizer. Here is my needle organizer which I created using felt material. You can keep your needles in a proper way by using a needle organizer. If you like our video, hit the like button below and leave a comment. Thanks for watching our videos.